जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड पुत्तळ वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
అందరికీ నమస్కారం వణకం మై వార్మ్ గ్రీటింగ్స్ టు హానరబుల్ చైర్మన్ లెజిస్లేటివ్ కౌన్సిల్ హానరబుల్ స్పీకర్ లెజిస్లేటివ్ అసెంబ్లీ అండ్ హానరబుల్ మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టేట్ లెజిస్లేచర్ ఆఫ్టర్ కంటిన్యూస్ అండ్ రిలెంట్లెస్ స్ట్రగుల్ ఫర్ 6 decades ది తెలంగాణ సొసైటీ కుడ్ ఏబుల్ టు అచీవ్ ఎ సెపరేట్ స్టేట్హుడ్ ది తెలంగాణ స్టేట్ అచీవ్డ్ వండర్ఫుల్ ప్రోగ్రెస్ ఇన్ సెవరల్ సెక్టర్స్ and became number one state in the country within a short span of time. This is something I am sure we all should rejoice and feel proud of. The advantage for Telangana state is that the leader who led the separate statehood movement himself became the chief minister of the newly formed state and leading it from front and getting marched towards the path of progress and development. The Telangana society, which was destroyed in all the sectors during the United Andhra Pradesh rule, now under the visionary and dynamic leadership of Chief Minister Sri Kalvakundala Chandrasekhar Rao, has been moving forward with perfect planning, sincerity and commitment ever since he took over the reins of state 6 years ago. I have no doubt that this forward movement is yielding good results now. If we make a comparison of the situation that existed when Telangana state was formed and now, the delightful achievements and success the state achieved in such a short span of time is being observed with admiration by the entire country. Situation that prevailed during the formation of the state. If we recollect the solid conditions that prevailed as on 2nd June 2014, when the Telangana state was formed, there were dire straits in all the sectors. In the initial days, the Telangana state faced severe power crisis and was reeling under severe regular power cuts. There was no minimum security for the lives of the poor and their livelihood. Suicides, starvation deaths, migration were become an order of the day. The meager rupees 200 per month pension given to the poor was not able to meet even their basic needs. The entire farm sector was pushed into a crisis. The situation was so pathetic that thousands of farmers who were in despair and distress used to commit suicides. Farmers used to suffer due to non-supply of quality seed, fertilizers and pesticides on time, and problem was more severe with sale and supply of spurious seeds, adulterated fertilizers and fake pesticides. Farmers had to struggle a lot to get investment to cultivate their crops. The situation was so grave that farmers used to raise private loans at an exorbitant interest rates. Owing to non-completion of the irrigation projects, there was no availability of water for agriculture. Farmers' future was bleak. Groundwater table dipped acutely due to large-scale destruction of tanks under the United Andhra Pradesh rule. The situation was so grim that even if a borewell was drilled up to 600 feet, 700 feet or even to 800 feet, there were no traces of water. Since power supply was hardly available even for 4 to 5 hours in a day, crops used to wither away. Even if some manages to get some produce, it would never get a proper support price in the market. With all these problems prevailing in the farm sector in Telangana, agriculture was regarded as a loss-making and waste profession. The allied trades and professions of the agriculture sector were also collapsed in the state, and people from these professionals often forced to migrate. This scenario is still fresh in our memories. The entire rural economy was disturbed, unorganized and uncertain future and beyond redemption with the collapse of both agriculture and its allied professions. The drinking water problem was severe and unbearable in Telangana society prior to the formation of the state. Health and education sectors were also collapsed. The situation was so bad that the poor had to borrow heavily and sell their belongings to get the deliveries done in the private and corporate hospitals. There were playing cards clubs in every basti. In cities and towns, a number of illicit liquor selling points in every village. Law and order was not under control. There was an onslaught of Telangana literature, culture, traditions and arts. No importance was given to Telangana temples and festivals. Under these trials and tribulations, on 2nd June 2014, the Telangana state started its journey under the foresighted leader who successfully spearheaded the separate statehood movement under the stewardship of Chief Minister Sri K. Chandrasekhar Rao. My government, after taking into consideration its resources, facilities, needs, advantages, disadvantages, strengths and weaknesses, had prepared short-term, mid-term, long-term plans for the overall development of the state and thus launched state's revitalization and rejuvenation process. Social welfare. In order to provide minimum security of livelihoods to the poor, my government had given top priority to welfare sector with lot of concern on humanitarian considerations. The welfare program are being designed and implemented with utmost humanitarian perspective by the Telangana government to give security to the lives and livelihood of the poor. A special development fund was created for the development and progress of the SC/ST sections. Allocations were made in the state budget in the proportion to their population ratio. To revive, revitalize and to strengthen the rural economy, my government gave the required financial stimulus to the hereditary professionals and artisans. Sheeps were distributed on large scale for the Golla Kuruma communities at 75% subsidy. Fishermen were given rights to fishing in reservoirs in the state, and my government has distributed free fish seedlings and dropped them into the reservoirs. Tax on palm trees is abolished. By purchasing cloth, uniforms and saris from the handloom weavers, my government has created market for their products. The input cost came down for the weavers as the government is giving 50% subsidy on the yarn, chemicals and colors. My government is giving financial assistance to the Nayi Brahmins and the washermen to set up modern saloons, purchase modern machines, washing machines respectively. My government had set up the most backward classes corruption corporation for the benefit of nomads and most backward classes. My government had allotted sites in Hyderabad to several BC communities to construct their respective community homes to uphold their self-respect. For the Telangana martyrs, my government gave rupees 10 lakh ex gratia amount and one job for each family. My government is extending rupees 6 lakh financial help to the families of farmers who have committed suicide. Rupees 6 lakh ex gratia amount is being paid to the families of toddy tappers, fishermen who lost their lives due to accidents. Rupees 5 lakh compensation is being given to families of the persons who lost their lives in natural calamities such as heavy rains, floods, etc. Rupees 6 lakh to the families of the persons who died during the lightning. My government has extended rupees 2 lakh per person who were dependent on illicit liquor trade earlier and now switched to alternate employment. Nutritious meal is given to pregnant women, women in postnatal period and babies at Anganwadi centers under Arogya Lakshmi scheme. My government regularized up to 125 square yards of land occupied by the poor free of cost for their dwelling units. Pattas were distributed to 1.25 lakh persons under regularization scheme as per GO number 58. Rupees 5 lakh insurance scheme is being implemented by my government for drivers, home guards, working journalists, and government is paying the premium for this scheme. A special fund is created for welfare of lawyers and journalists. Brahmin Sakshema Parishad was formed for the welfare of poor Brahmins. Priests in the temples were given salaries regularly on par with the government employees under Dhoopa Deepa Naivedyam scheme. Imams and Muezzins who conduct prayers in masjids were given rupees 500 per month as allowance. Successes in power sector. My government acted swiftly and strategically to overcome the crisis prevailing in the power sector. As a result, Telangana state registered spectacular and unprecedented accomplishment in power sector. Today, Telangana has become the state that utilizes highest per capita power in the country. The peak demand in the United Andhra Pradesh stood at 13,162 megawatts, where in Telangana it crossed that figure and the demand reached an all-time high of 13,168 megawatts. In spite of all-time high demand, power supply was supplied without any interruption, and this itself an evidentiary tall proof of our glorious success in power sector. Now, uninterrupted quality power is supplied 24/7 for all sectors in the state. I feel proud to declare that Telangana state is one and the only state in the country which is supplying free 24/7 high quality power to its farm sector. The installed capacity at the time of formation of the state was only 7,778 megawatts, whereas the installed capacity now in the state is 16,246 megawatts. Construction of new power plants in the fast track to make Telangana a power surplus state. Progress in agriculture sector. Majority of the people in the state are dependent on agriculture. Owing to the negligent, indifferent attitude and lack of policy of the erstwhile rulers, the farm sector was nudged into terrible crisis. My government made every step forward with proper planning to pull up the farm sector from the crisis and instill confidence and hope among the farmers. My government is supplying quality seeds, fertilizers and pesticides on time to the farmers as per their requirements. Stringent action is being taken under the Preventive Detention Act, PD Act, against those indulging in supply of spurious seeds, adulterated fertilizers and fake pesticides. With 24 hour uninterrupted power supply, farmers are able to bring their entire land under cultivation and deriving high crop yielding. irrigation sector construction of projects. My government with an aim to provide water for irrigation to 1 crore acres prepared and implementing a comprehensive irrigation plan. Devadula for 365 days and are also on fast track. My government is making all out efforts to complete works on this barrage in this summer itself. My government has sanctioned Sitamma Sagar barrage with about 40 TMC capacity, which is capable of producing 320 megawatts hydel power and also supply water to Sitarama project in the existing place in the present Dummukudam Anikat. I am happily announcing that the works on this barrage will commence shortly. The ample proof that the Telangana irrigation sector has progressed extremely well is the marvelous achievement in the increased acreage of the paddy cultivation in the summer crop. In the normal course, the paddy crop area growing during the summer season in Telangana is 17,8,397 acres. Owing to the progress made in the irrigation sector during this summer season, the paddy crop was grown in 38,19,419 acres as recorded by Agriculture Department. Before the state's formation, not even one primary health center was up to the national quality of accredited standards. But now there are 84 PHCs of the SQAS level state quality accreditation standards. Our state stood first in this category in the entire country. In the past, there were only 22 newborn care centers in existence and my government decided to increase them to 42. Already, 6 newborn care centers have begun functioning and another 14 will be launched soon. In the past, there were only 5 government medical colleges and my government had started 4 more and thus increasing the government medical colleges strength to 9. There is steep increase in the number of institutional deliveries in the government hospitals due to the KCR kits. Proper care is being given to both mother and the newborn. At the time of formation of the state, the maternal mortality rate was 92 deaths per lakh. This has come down to 76 now. Similarly, the infant mortality, which was 39 per thousand, has come down to 29 per thousand now. The percentage of institutional deliveries in the government hospitals has been increased by 22%. In the past, only 68% of the population was vaccinated, whereas now the state registered 96% immunization and stood first in the country. There is 20% increase in inpatient rate in the government hospitals. My government achieved a new record by conducting a biggest eye screening drive under Kanti Velugu program. Eye screening tests were conducted on 1.54 crore people. 41 lakh people were given free spectacles and medicines free of cost. My government has decided to conduct ENT screening tests on the lines of Kanti Velugu by organizing camps. After conducting all the tests, the Telangana state health profile will be prepared. My government will shortly announce an action plan in this regard. The Basti Dawakanas run by the government in Hyderabad proved to be very useful for the urban poor. My government has decided to increase number of Basti Dawakanas in the areas where majority of people are from SC, ST, minorities and poor to provide better medical and health services. My government has decided to open at least 2 Basti Dawakanas in every division in Hyderabad city and the number will be increased if the poor are more in the area. Thus, my government has decided to set up 350 Basti Dawakanas in the Hyderabad and to give free treatment and medicines to the poor. It is an inspiring movement for us that our state is one among the best 3 states which are offering better quality medical facilities in the country. Administrative reform. undertaken administrative reforms in a big way scientifically. 10 districts in the state were increased to 33. 43 revenue divisions were increased to 73. 459 mandals were increased to 590. 5 came 128. Municipal corporations increased from 6 to 13 and thus making 141 urban local bodies in the state. Gram panchayats were increased from 8,690 to 12,751. Administration and monitoring. There were only 2 police commissionerates in the state before the formation of the Telangana state. My government has set up 7 more to increase the number to 9. Police subdivisions were increased from 139 to 164. Police circles from 688 to 719. And the police stations from 712 to 815. To protect the rights of local citizens in the newly formed districts, my government created a new zonal system. There will be peace and harmony in the citizens' life, and progress can be achieved without any hindrances. Hence, my government gave top priority to strengthen the police department. Besides revamping the police department to suit to the present day needs, my government allocated funds for the department to the scale which was never happened in the past. For the maintenance of law and order, 6 lakh CC cameras in the state were installed. This accounts for 66% CC cameras in the country. The command control center, which is being constructed with international standards, will be launched shortly. The Telangana police have taken up special drive for women's safety. She teams are actively functioning in Hyderabad and elsewhere in the state and have been providing safety for the women. Ganga, Jamuna, Tagjeeb and Telangana. Telangana is known for its Ganga, Jamuna, Tagjeeb. Telangana state is the symbol of communal harmony. People from all faiths are living here peacefully with harmony for centuries together. Let me declare here that my government is fully committed to uphold the unity among its people and to protect the secular fabric of the state. My government will respect every religion and celebrate all festivals. My government will act sternly against those who are trying to create communal tensions and suppress the attempts with an iron hand.
Praja Jyoti News Channel ni like cheyandi, share cheyandi, subscribe chesi bell icon ni click cheyandi. Please subscribe Praja Jyoti News. Thanks for watching.
Praja Jyoti prati aksharam praja gontukai. Praja Jyoti prati gontuka simha gajjanai.